Hi, I'm Patrick. Creating a video as to what you need to do last week before DCAT. I thought it's important and therefore I thought let me make an elaborate PPT video for the same. Now, two kinds of people that I looked at. I mean, one who have not prepared much. So you're a person who has just started preparing, let's say 15 days before DCAT. Or you're a person who has just written two or three mocks. Then start studying hard. I mean, don't stop preparing. Prepare for the last 1 week. Write three mocks on alternate days if possible. Right, study for 6-7 hours every day, analyze them thoroughly, both for strategy and looking at your mistakes. Okay, from the remaining time, pick up questions from the different mocks or past CAT papers and start solving them. Also, ensure that you read every day. Reading is very, very important for 1 hour at least. So, do like you normally prepare, prepare hard, maybe 6-7 hours a day from Monday to Friday. You can take a break on Saturday to just to relax your mind. But prepare hard from Monday to Friday, 1 week before the exam. But if you're already prepared, one is be happy with it. Give yourself a pat. It's not easy to prepare for CAT. It requires 4, 5, 6 months of continuous preparation. So there will be flaws in your preparation. You must have taken a break. You're not happy with your preparation. All that is fine. But give yourself a pat that you have come up to this particular extent that you have given a shot for the CAT. I've seen so many people giving up your CAT preparation. They start, but it's not difficult to continue till the examination. If you've done that, be happy and, you know, be happy with that achievement at least. But also realize that if you have not been able to improve your scores from last, let's say, 3 months or whatever, last 1 week will not improve your score suddenly. I'm not saying that your score will not score well. Okay, I'm just saying that practice may not improve your score. What will make a difference is the mind frame. So that means now what you need to focus on is trying to improve your mind frame. I mean, I've seen people where my proper mind frame can make a lot of difference in the examination. How can you understand what a mind frame is or the psychological effect of the exam? If you write a mock, you will realize there are a lot of questions for which you get the answers after the mock. And this is true for everyone. I mean, once you stop the mock, you will get the answer for some of the questions if you start going to it again, which you didn't get in the exam. That is because of stress, and everyone faces it, including me, including everyone. There will be some amount of stress. The key is to try to minimize the stress as far as possible. So I've seen students who score very high in the mock, 99.5 plus, etc., but end up with maybe less than 95 purely because they are under stress. Very few. I mean, I don't see many people in this bracket. There could be a few. Very few, but yes, if you panic, there's a chance that you will lower your score. I've also seen students, and a lot of them, who score low in the mocks but end up scoring really high in the actual CAT, right? Because they are more relaxed and they are able to prepare, do well as far as the examination goes. Most of them end up with a similar score, maybe a little more, little less, but similar score than what they scored in the mocks. Now, how do you ensure that you relax your mind and help you to score, help you to score better in the examination? Okay, trying to help you understand that, I'll give you a couple of examples of my own CAT and other exams. For example, when I first wrote the CAT exam, my college exams were there in the week before the CAT, Monday to Friday. College administration purposely kept the examination Monday to Friday so that people don't write the CAT. And CAT exam was on Sunday in some other city. So we had to study very hard on Monday to Friday because as usual, like a normal engineering college, we only study on the last moment, day and night before the exam. Before that, we never had notes also. And because we were all tired from preparing for the college exam, we had no hope. I mean, people said like, how? I mean, after 6 days of night out and then traveling to other city, there was almost no hope anyone had. So we are more relaxed because we didn't have any hope for the examination. And because we were more relaxed, what ended up was that we had maximum IM calls that year compared to the previous years. And why was that? Because there was no stress of getting calls. We were more relaxed. It is not a preparation that helped us to be better, because we were as prepared as what maybe every other batch was prepared. But we were more relaxed, that helped us to perform better in the exam. My first CT exam. When I was there preparing for the CT exam, there were many people better than me. I had students who had more IM calls. I had no IM calls out that year. And many people who are really much better than me who are writing the examination. As a matter of fact, one of my friend who was getting into IIM Bangalore that year, he discouraged me. He clearly said, I know you, tere se nahi hoga. I mean, he very clearly mentioned, he said, there's too much of competition and too few seats. So I think it's not possible in your case. So I prepared mentally that I'll write the CAT exam again next year. Okay, that was mentally prepared for. But I prepared. In a sense, I wrote mocks, I analyzed, I did everything which was there. A day before the exam, I saw a movie till 2 p.m. in the night. It was a movie called Independence Day, which came first time in the on television. And once I start seeing a movie, I keep seeing it till it gets over. So I saw it till 2 p.m. in the night. Next morning, I had an exam at 9 a.m. So I got up at 5 o'clock and went for the examination. So I had hardly any sleep. But when the result came out, I scored a rank 3. I hardly ever scored top 10 ranks in the mock I gave, one mock type of mock, where there were hardly any students writing the mock, not even one of the top classes. Not scoring top rank, 10 rank in any of the mocks to scoring rank 3 overall was a great jump. And that only happened because there was not much of stress. I was more relaxed as far as the examination is concerned. So how do you relax yourself? One, let's start looking at alternatives. Okay, don't make CAT a do or die situation. That will only increase your stress. Don't say that CAT nahi hoga to kuch nahi hoga. Give your best shot. I'm not saying don't give your best shot. Give your best shot. Okay, but don't make it a do or die situation. Look at alternatives. Like maybe you can give CAT next year. Maybe GMAT, maybe ZAT, maybe CET, maybe job, maybe business. Could be anything. I don't know what life has stolen for you. Okay. Or think of what you can do after the CAT examination. Like prepare for ZAT exam, prepare for SNAP exam, whatever. But try to move your mind off CAT. Also, maybe you can indulge in hobbies. I mean, that could also help you to move your mind off CAT. Don't think that if you don't do well in CAT, it's all gone. Remember when I gave my CAT for the second time, I did expect to get a call. I prepared very hard for the same. I didn't get a call. Was it the end for me? No, I did well in CET. I got into Bajaj and I'm happy today where I am. Maybe if I had cracked CAT that year, I would not be where I am today. I don't know. So everything happens for the best. And that is the theme for the next slide. Everything happens for the best is what I believe. I've seen a lot of my students who have done well. Here specifically, I'll be giving examples of students who have not cracked the CAT examination but are still doing well. So one of my students studied hard for the exam, didn't get into a good college, but he liked cricket. So he started writing about cricket. Okay. And slowly his articles started getting published. Today he's working in Star Sports. I mean, I was shocked to see him along with Ranveer Singh in one 10-minute exclusive film about him on television. I mean, and the whole film was to commemorate his achievement on the cricket comment. So amazing. I mean, I saw him and I was like, glad he could achieve that level. One more student of mine couldn't make it to college, moved to journalism. I saw him after a few years in CNBC as an anchor. He is now working in Wall Street Journal in a Singapore office and doing extremely well in his field. I mean, he is a known name. I know other people who know him as a person who has achieved a great deal. Not crack CAT. Another of my students didn't crack CAT, moved to events. Events with Bollywood stars, Shah Rukh Khan, etc. And I see his photograph continuously on social media, which is again amazing. So that means if I don't crack, that doesn't mean it ends everything. There could be something in store for you, and think about it. Everything happens for the best. As long as you're relaxed and you do well in the examination, everything will happen. Maybe CAT is there for you, maybe CAT is not there for you. But there'll be something in store for you which will make your career. Don't worry about it. Okay, now what you need exactly to do in the last week, plan for the last week. If you're prepared well before, maybe you can write one or two mocks during the last week. If you don't write also, it's not a problem, but you can write if you want one or two mocks during the last week. Don't overdo your mocks. Okay, but read every day for 1 hour at least. This is important because what I've realized is that the more you read closer to the examination, the better it is. Read the day of the exam also. Reading is most important and keep it up till the examination day. Do a little max and DLR to keep in touch. Take a few questions from here and there. Focus on max, focus on DLR, and do a little max and DLR. Focus more on your weak areas. So if you feel DLR is a little weak, maybe more questions on DLR. If max question is weak, focus on max. Also, focus on revisiting your previous mocks. Okay, go back to your previous mocks and check out what mistakes have you done and try to improve on that. Okay, focus on the mistakes that you've done in the previous mocks. Look at a strategy that you failed and strategy that succeeded for you in the previous mocks. So focus on analyzing your previous mocks. That is important. I've not put it as a pointer, but it is a very important point that you need to look at previous mocks and look at strategy and mistakes. Prepare for 4-5 hours if you're at home. I mean, if you were preparing for 7-8 hours earlier, you can maybe make it to 4 or 5 hours and try to reduce your time. Okay, don't stress yourself too much for the exam. But be active during the time of your exam. So if your time of the exam is in the afternoon, ensure that you're active during that time. Because the biological clock ensures that whatever you do at particular time, it continues. So if you're sleeping at a particular time, you may feel exactly sleepy on the next day at the same time. To ensure that time when you're maintaining, when you're awake, try to be awake at that time. Or ensure that you follow particular pattern that you follow during the examination day also. That helps to know. Okay, get more involved in favorite activities like hobbies, etc. One more thing that someone had told me recently was, though I don't follow that, is that look at your eating habits also. Suppose you eat something, okay, and you go for the examination. So eat the same thing every day and check out whether it follows or not. Because some people, sometimes they eat too much before the examination and they feel sleepy during the examination. Sometimes you eat too little and then you realize that you're hungry during the examination. It eats up your energy. To ensure that the eating habits are normalized during the week, that helps. So keep your eating habits in a normal, proper pattern. Right? So follow this. I'm sure it will help you with regards to CAT. Just relax, enjoy your journey, and I'm sure you'll do well in your career. Thank you.